So, last we left off, you managed to save the child, as you previously said, got them outside and back to their mother, who then gave them a scolding, hit them, and walked away with them, after you had done your little deal. You're now left near the cave entrance, looking down the road as they slowly disappear around the bend in the tree line. You're hurt, you're tired. You're alright. What are you gonna do?
Okay. Well,
I think
first.
We should go back to the shop. Patch ourselves up a bit.
Well, you know, we do need a plan, don't we? And I did actually just think of something just in this brief moment that they were walking down the road. I wonder if that crackpot inventor has anything that might be useful. Because, I mean, he gave us these distraction rocks, which I'm not really sure, actually. I think we definitely need to make use of these somehow, but what did you do, Kara? Like, you threw one of them, and then I just heard a massive explosion.
That's cool. I just threw it at him.
Oh.
Right. Second try didn't work so well.
What happened the second time? I must be honest, I wasn't really paying attention.
It was just my voice that came out of the rock.
Oh, okay. Did you record a message into it or something?
No.
All right, so it just kind of mimics. Okay, so the effects are random then. I think actually we... yeah, because didn't it just like give off a smell back in the market when the merchant tested it?
Yeah, the first one basically farted.
Right, okay, so... yeah... I don't know. I would vote for heading back to Gilbert Town to maybe have a chat with them, see if they've got anything, or if you guys prefer, we can just go and rest somewhere, I guess, for a little bit.
Yeah, I'm hurt, so as long as we don't fight anything, I'm okay with it.
Just a quick rest.
Looking at this, we can do this at least a couple of times, can't we? Short rests. Well, actually, no, it's to do with this hit dice, so it looks like we only have one of them at the moment.
But we're able, out of character, we did short rest last session.
Yeah, I know, I'm just kind of saying this for flavor with Brandon.
Is it rule saying we can't do more than one short rest?
Well, I mean, looking at my sheet here, it looks like you can only... You're basically using these hit die whenever...
Duke gets this, what's it called? Mm-hmm. Spell? Midding? Slots? Back?
Oh, yeah. Like, the spell slots, like when I use the Bernie hand thing. I think I...
Yeah.
Get yours back on a short rest?
Yeah,
okay.
I need a quick little rest in the back.
Shit, I don't have that.
Spells? What spells?
Oh, yeah, I guess... there's an extra section on... I think basically on everyone but your character. I don't know if you have spells on your character sheet. Yeah, there's a section specifically for it. But I'm guessing not all of us have that.
Maybe.
But anyway, do we want to go to Gilbert Town, or do you just want to try this again?
This what, the mine, or...
Well, yeah, because I think it's pretty clear that we're not going to find a snow deer just by wandering around, as we proved the other day. Well, yesterday, I should say. God, these just seem to run together now.
Cool. However, I'm not going back in there today.
Too beat up to try that again.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying I particularly want to. It's just whether we want to, well, not go in again today. Because, I mean, we have just rested. It depends on how we approach it, I guess. I mean, I'm the guy who's basically been saying all along I don't want to go in there, but... I'm just asking.
We're trying not to go in there. You want to go in there.
What can I say? I am a contrarian. But all jokes aside, fuck it. Let's just go to Gilbert Town and talk to that merchant again. Maybe they might have something that can help us with this. If nothing else, we'll just kill time until we can long rest again.
Yeah. I'm okay with it.
Alright, onwards and upwards. I don't know where I've heard that expression before, but it sounds cool, so I'm saying it.
Whatever.
I mean, I guess onwards, but why up?
I don't know. Like, it kind of just sounds like, you know, you're going upwards. You know, it sounds positive. It sounds uplifting, as it were.
True, but we cannot fly.
Are you sure? I mean, I didn't think we could do most of the stuff that we can do. Oh, actually, that's a point. I wonder if there's like a fly spell.
That would be dope.
Yeah, that would be pretty sick. I mean, we already have tails, well, you know, me and Kara do, so I don't reckon that wings are completely out of the equation.
I wonder if you get devil-like wings.
Oh, yeah, that's actually a point. Brandon briefly touches up his back around his spine to see whether there's like any sort of like bones there that might form into wings. And it's like, maybe there might be a type of, what did that merchant call them? Tieflings? Yeah, tieflings that get wings, but I don't think I do.
Seems like we don't really know what we can do.
Well, not yet. I mean, I've actually noticed we've got like an XP bar.
Yeah,
I noticed it went up by a little bit when we came out the mine. But it curiously didn't move the last time it went into there.
What do you think happens if it goes up?
Looking at my sheet, there's like an LV1 on the left side and LV2 on the right side. So it's a progress bar, essentially. So if it goes all the way to the right side, I assume we go to level 2, basically.
That's what we need to do.
I wonder what...
You'll see Carl like trying to pull at something in midair that's looking at her and trying to move it.
No. I don't think it works like that. It's... I'm guessing it's reacting to certain things that we do, but...
Do you think we got it from helping the goblin child?
Well, I've not really been watching it that closely, so I don't know. I mean, like I say, I saw it move when we came out of there, so maybe so.
Because we didn't get it the first time we entered, and the difference is we helped somebody.
Huh. Okay, so...
Who did we help the first time, then?
That's a good point.
Are we moving while talking, by the way?
Yeah, I think Brandon will be, yeah.
Perhaps it's just like farming mobs. Creature spawn and you can
we mustn't
get
be
rid of them for points.
I mean, we mustn't be... The thing is, though, what does everyone's sheet say? Do we all have the same value? I've got 150 on mine.
I'm halfway, so 150 as well.
Right, okay. Okay, so it's not based on individual kills then, because I've certainly not taken out as many of those slimes as, let's say, David has.
Do we have, like, XP share in this part?
I guess.
Those old Pokemon games, XP share?
Yeah!
Exactly. Oh, no, don't go on about XP share. That ruined Pokemon for me. Like the grind was definitely the best part of that game. You had to earn your Pokemon EXP.
Alright, give your XP back to the others then.
Well, I would if I could. Sorry, I don't usually... Wow, that was a weirdly passionate opinion. God, I buried that. I buried that one deep. God.
Nerds.
Hey, I make no secrets of it. At least I have an interest, Kara.
Ooh.
Ooh. I have interests.
Such as...
Except of men.
Food's an interest.
I mean, that's something we just kind of need in order to survive. I mean, I think it's fair to say that everyone is interested in food, you know, as something to eat, but, you know, like, I don't know. I mean, like, maybe, I'm not really a foodie. I mean, you're more of a foodie, John, than me.
I like to go to coffee shops.
That's something.
Yeah,
I don't
okay.
know. That's quite basic. I'm sorry, Kara.
Okay.
Do they have coffee in this world?
That's actually oh god, I didn't even think about that.
I don't think so, because traditionally coffee came from much warmer places. Well, and this looks.
Maybe they do have it, but it just doesn't grow here.
But or maybe.
Yeah, yeah.
Or it might. Or it's maybe known under a different name, maybe?
That's also a possibility.
Well, since we are going to the town anyway, I could ask.
Yeah, why not? Okay, well, I reckon we get our heads down and just made the journey. Not that we're in any particular rush, but yeah, I just kind of want to see if we can get something of value from that merchant, and well, maybe the next time we go into those mines the last time.
Okay, I assume you're mostly staying south for the remainder of the walk?
Unless anyone else has got anything to say.
Carol will be sulking because she got cold yesterday.
Okay, okay. You reapproach the little town. At the bridge, there is a single guard on duty this time, not one that you've seen previously. As you're walking up, he stands at attention in the center of the bridge and holds up his hand. Halt! What's your business?
Just here for a bit of like shopping. We wanted to visit one of the merchants that we visited yesterday.
Ah, you're returning. Excellent. He steps aside. Hopefully, let you go pass.
I continue.
Does Brandon.
You make your way back in, battered and bruised. A few people in the centre look at you as you walk in, then go back about their business. The stalls all here from that you were here for last time. You notice that the one with the flowers seems to catch Jun's eye. He waves.
I wave back.
He holds up a little pouch, pointing towards it.
Is it the same kind of pouch I bought earlier?
Yep.
I lightly shake my head, but smile.
He shoulders cycle up it and nods in the pouch away.
I think we make our way to the merchants, right?
I think they were this stall, if I remember right. Correct.
As you approach, he is not currently at the stall, but you can hear rummaging behind the sort of desk he has.
Excuse me.
Fine. His head peeks up, his horns going first. Yes. Oh, hello. How are you today?
Could be better.
Ah.
You?
Hey, a little bit beaten up. Some of those burn marks there, I see.
Yeah, slimes.
Ooh, nasty things.
Yeah.
Oh, you found a healing slime, they're quite good.
Healing slime?
Ah, yes. It's much like a acid slime, but instead of being all acidy, it's all healy.
How does it look?
It depends on the form of healing potion that's been used in it. Normally they come in a red variety. It's more or less a slime that's just been created using healing potions as the main ingredients. Often you'll see them built up from whatever fluids are around. Acid is quite a common one, but you also see poop slimes occasionally.
You?
Yes, very nasty things. No one ever wants to kill them either, because it's poop.
How do you make these healing slimes?
Well, you need a slime core, or you need to have... Basically, you need to be able to make a particular arcane circle, which will form a core based on the ingredients you use in the circle. And around that core, you'll normally start to blend it with various fluids of your choosing. In which case your healing potions might be quite expensive. It might take a fair few gold worth to actually make it. And you need to have a certain amount of magical strength in its creation. They do occur naturally in the world, but the more naturally, it's the less desirable ones.
Probably rare, I assume.
Well, slimes tend to be quite common, to be honest. It's a common occurrence. But a healing slime, in the wild, maybe if there was a puddle full of healing ointment that had been left for weeks, possibly.
Interesting. Thanks for the information.
Not always.
We're actually here to purchase some of your distraction rocks.
Oh, you like some more? Excellent.
If you have something more potent in the explosion variety, that would also be interesting.
Oh, I can sell you some boom boxes.
How much are they?
A boom box is 5 silver a boom.
Ooh, actually, could I ask something about the boombox? Sorry, I kind of just butted into this conversation, but I'm just very curious.
Go ahead.
So how do they work again?
Oh, well, it's relatively simple. You just have to have the rocks in the box, you strike kind of a... Well, there's a few ways you can activate them. Would you prefer verbal, or would you prefer manual, or would you prefer magical?
Well, my question was basically going to be, like, if we did it like verbal or magical, we could do that from, like, how far away could we do that from?
If it's going to be a verbal, it needs to be within hearing range, so it depends how much you want to shout. How strong your voice is.
Like, make my voice really loud?
I feel that would probably defeat the object, Sumkara.
I mean, it might be useful.
Honestly, I was just wondering, like, with the manual way, do any of these have, like, I don't know, like, a crank that you could wind up so you could kind of, like, put it on a timer?
A crank? Oh, that sounds awful complex, to be honest. Not a crank, no.
Can I throw something at something?
Basically, I just want to know if there's perhaps a way that we can delay the activation of it for maybe about, I don't know, about 10, 20 seconds.
If we put up a string and light it up at one end and the string goes to the
Yeah, you were thinking like a fuse, yeah.
Because I have flint and steel, I think, what's it called? Let me check my
own. The main manual activation for these is you see this strip on the side right here. He directs to one side. You strike your nail across it and use the activation word. It will have about 5 seconds till it will go off.
Honestly, that might still... That's better than nothing.
But not a lot, 5 seconds.
Well, it isn't, but it's better than instant.
Long enough to normally not be holding in.
Say, hypothetically, I threw one into the body of a slime. Did that blow it up?
What type of slimes are we talking about? Depends on the size, I suppose. Smaller ones, yeah, it'll probably do it, more or less.
You also have bigger slimes?
Oh, yes.
Oh, no.
How big are your slimes?
I make a gesture with my hands, about this-ish.
Oh, yeah, they are on the smaller variety. Yeah, that should be no problem. For the bigger ones, though, if you gesture kind of like about his arm's length apart, it was like that big, you're probably gonna have a bit more trouble.
I hope we will never find one that big.
Oh, well, sadly, they tend to be a natural occurrence. Chances are, if there's a bunch of small ones wherever you're going, then there's gonna be bigger ones as well.
Thanks for that, son.
Actually, I have a second question, and kind of related to the first. You don't happen to have anything that could kind of give us, I don't know, some form of protection? against Dasa? I mean, it seems to be whenever we've interacted with them, they've burned us, so it... Yeah, that's something that just kind of resists acid, I guess. Or know of anyone who might have something like that.
I might not, but I might know somewhere where I could procure an ointment that might help.
Ooh,
it may not last long, but...
How long is not long? Roughly.
I believe it might be about 10 minutes.
Sounds decent.
Honestly, enough. I would take that over nothing.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Do we have to go to Granny's place for that?
No, I know someone that can procure it.
And there's another Granny? It is Granny, isn't it? It is Granny. All right, thanks.
Nope. Damn it!
Brandon's actually just stood there. He isn't leaving with David.
We still want some distraction rocks, don't worry. You're not leaving empty-handed.
He'll do the trade for what, same deal as before for the distraction rocks.
Buying the distraction ones or the boomy ones?
Say we want a specific feature from these rocks? Is that possible?
No, I'm afraid not. The enchantments kind of makes it a bit random.
Okay, so it's as we thought then.
Oh, kind of like Brandon.
What, sorry?
Kind of random. Brandon.
Brandon does magic randomly sometimes.
Yeah, actually, that's... Yeah, I suppose that's also true.
He's only a distraction rock.
He's a distraction rock!
It's not the worst thing I've been called, so I can believe you may.
What would happen if you throw Brandon in this?
No, you are not throwing me at the slimes!
That's an idea.
No, it is not!
It's not a pleasant
feeling. Maybe at the bigger ones.
Actually, come to think of it...
Like a,
okay, sorry.
You were thinking of...
Oh no, I was actually just thinking, like, when I was down in those mines, I didn't even get... Like, David, I thought you were about to say that, you know, those slimes aren't pleasant, but what the fuck did you hit me with?
I don't know what it was.
Well, did you not read it?
I saw a name and I thought, oh, that's cool, and I saw the... In the notes, it says 10 feet surrounded around myself, deals damage. I'm like, sure, let's try that.
Hold up. We were in an enclosed space. I was in front of you, and you cast it anyway.
Hey, David attacked you?
Yes! You admitted to it.
We all had that urge, to be fair. We all had that urge.
No, we didn't. Wait, what are you talking about, Kara?
What? Okay.
I thought that I could take at least two of the three out with
And did you?
I took one out. And hurt the other two. So.
Yes, and almost killed me.
Anyway. The chat was the other way.
And I also healed you.
Oh, yes, you did, I suppose. But now I've got the scar on my back, courtesy of you, so thanks for that. Anyway, sorry, bygones be bygones, I know, just forgive and forget.
I will try not to do that again.
Please, if you can avoid it, don't. No, you can heal me again, but don't do the 10-foot thing again, if you can. Well, not with me there, at least, if you can help it, please, thank you.
So, if June is there, it's okay.
Did you hit one of the slimes with it?
I hit three of them.
Huh.
For four in total.
So, how many rocks are we buying?
I'm more interested in the boombox.
Yeah, because we've already got a few distraction rocks, don't we? I mean, I suppose if you wanted to get a couple more for the road, because it do seem like they could be, you know, generally useful. Yeah, it's up to you, though. You've got the piggy bank, David.
Nah, you all have.
Brandon searches his pouch to find the tangled. Yeah, that is true. You did give us some spending money. Thank you. Okay, so how much are these boomboxes then? Asking the merchant.
5 silver.
5 silver each.
Any one for the book purchase of 4 of us buying?
Depends how many you're buying.
I was thinking of maybe 5 for myself. What were you guys thinking?
I mean, yeah, because we probably want to at least have a couple of spare, and, you know, this might be useful again. I tell you what, I'll put 5 silver... I'll put 10 silver. I'll buy 2 of them if you guys want to make up the difference.
2, 7... How much were you thinking, Kara?
Oh, I don't want any. I just want more rocks.
1? Oh, just rocks. How many rocks do you want?
About 7?
I turn my head towards the merchant. How much are the distraction rocks again?
5.
5 copper?
Silver.
The distraction rocks.
Look at the merchant. They're the same price as the boom ones, right?
Yeah.
Copper. No.
You're extremely bad at lying. Just be honest. It's better.
2 copper each.
2 copper.
Well, that's a big difference.
Yes. It's a good job we're with you, John.
Now, think the business you'd get if once people found out you supplied the heroes that destroyed the spy cave. I think that's better than a discount.
Edward, maybe, possibly. How much more do you want? 7 booms. However many distractions.
7 rocks for me. How many? What are you guys getting?
I was paying for 2 of these boom boxes. I think we wanted to get 5 in total, so... Whoever wants to pile
me
up. Yeah,
so do 5 boom boxes and 7 distraction rocks.
Make it 7 boom boxes. I give...
Alright, 7 boom box, 7 distraction rocks. So that will be 14 copper normally.
Right.
And 3.5 gold. Let's say 3 gold for everything.
Roll me persuasion. I'll give you advantage on it as well.
Oh, that's religion.
I mean, to some people, trade is religion.
Heard about Jesus.
No. Interesting fact. Did you know charity? No. Advantage. 1921.
Hey, pretty good. Very good.
What is the key? In that role?
I don't know. Probably highest one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, sure. 3 gold.
I give him the 3 gold.
Well, have a nice visit.
Thank you.
Thanks.
They're all the manual boxes, unless you want any of us.
No, I think we're good for now. Maybe we'll be back in the future, who knows? If we're not dead.
Okie dokie. Well, have a pleasant day and pleasant journeys. Have you gone?
Ooh, actually, one thing.
Yeah, tomorrow.
One thing, that ointment you mentioned, how long will it... Oh, is it at Granny's then?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I suppose we'll be paying a visit there next.
Hey, I'm not going to see that hag again.
Don't be mean towards your grandmother.
I mean, if it's so much of a problem, you could just say, stay outside. I mean, I feel if I go back in there, she'll just shoo me out of that bloody bush again.
Is there a coffee shop in this place?
Actually, that's a good thing. Hey, yeah, is coffee a thing here?
Is what a thing?
Coffee. It's like a bitter drink. It's, gives you a bunch of energy when you drink it. Maybe a bit exotic.
You mean bitter brew?
I guess. Yeah, I mean, I guess it's might be called something else.
Is it made from roasted beans that are like dark?
Oh no, it's made from these really thick leaves. You kind of make a mucus out of them.
Maybe that's tea then. It sounds about as disgusting.
Tea shouldn't be like mucus though.
Where can we find it?
There are establishments.
Hey Johnny, are you doing okay though?
Is there a place that sells these beverages?
You might get lucky in a tavern, but otherwise probably only the rich.
I see.
What are you implying?
Ooh, a tavern? I've never been to a tavern before.
I mean, you're buying stuff from me, so I'm going to assume you're not rich.
You're the first person we saw here.
Are you normally cheap?
I am a street merchant, so I don't even own a shop.
Yeah, but that's because you're traveling.
Some of the best places from where I'm from on the street.
Not always. You don't want to eat street meat.
Nothing wrong with street meat.
I like to find a street meat.
There's another vendor further along who's roasting some meat, and he kind of looks up, catching a whiff of this conversation. He glares at you.
There's a lot of hygienic issues with it.
Street food is alright.
Nothing wrong with my street meat.
Hey,
what kind of meat is it?
Rat.
Yeah, see? Case in point.
I mean, maybe it's... I don't want to appropriate it. You know, maybe it's a local thing here. Rats, though, the fuck?
A rat is also anyway, as long as from your fingertip to your shoulder. I've been roasted.
So it's like a hog roast, but it's a rat?
Yeah.
How does it smell?
It smells like roasting meat. So, good. All right. There's some herbs in the scent as well.
You know what, guys? That actually smells pretty good. I might get some.
That's a rat.
I advise against it.
I would very much advise against it, actually, considering... You say you don't want to go back to Granny's, but you're doing the exact sort of thing that is going to force us to take you there.
At this point, he's waving Kara over.
Oh, thank
you. Come on, give me a try. I don't know what you're missing.
Oh, it can be. That's what you're missing.
He's shaving some bits off it. Onto a bun at the moment.
Oh my god, he's making kebab.
Okay, but this now tempting me.
I'll have one of those. I'll just point at it.
It's 2 copper pieces.
I will hand over 2 copper pieces.
He hands you over what is effectively a small kebab of rat meat.
I will eat this.
McGurk, you eat it. It's. Actually has a bit of a sweet flavour to it. The meat tastes somewhat similar to chicken, but there is some kind of seasoning on it, which is quite sweet, a little bit tangy actually as well. It goes down quite nicely.
Guys, have you ever been to that chicken place down by the clubs? I'll say munching kebab.
But that isn't chicken.
I don't know, I'm always
too
wasted to tell its name.
Oh no.
It says the
one on the corner.
Oh, sure.
Tastes really good.
You're eating vermin.
You literally are.
It looks good though. I can't blame her.
John, no. We don't need two. We don't need two people with food poisoning. It's too late for Kara, I think.
I mean, no offense to your tacos, Miss Martinez, but.
Come on.
There is no way that I accept this kind of disrespect that you are.
No, I mean your tacos were delicious. That's what I'm trying to say. I steam kebab.
You've not even tried the rat, and you're saying that it's better than David's actual.
No, that's not what I'm trying to compliment David. I said his tacos were good. I'm seeing kebab, and I like what I see.
That does not sound like a compliment.
You're literally comparing it to vermin.
It's visual. Okay, I'm not gonna eat massive splinter over here.
Hey, guys, before...
I'll be like, looking at my fingers clean when I've done.
Oh, God. Oh, no. No. Oh, no.
Guys, it's like, that's so good.
Normal things here. Maybe they
what
don't...
What is wrong with you?
I mean, at this point, it's just natural selection.
Yes, I agree. Hey, I don't really have a segue to this. Do we just want to go to the herbalist and just get, yeah, try and get this lotion?
The merchant also told us there are better shops. Maybe we should check some of the shops.
That one's really good, Sir Vendor.
Quite bitter leaf.
Just kiss.
Let's check Granny's first.
I mean, it's no
he smiles at you. Blow out of holding his arms over his chest.
My friends have no taste, as you can tell.
No, we you know what? No.
Yeah, I can tell.
I'm going to be polite and stay quiet.
There's a saying where I'm from. It goes like, the farmer doesn't eat what he doesn't know. And that's kind of our problem, Mr. Meat Man.
You don't know rats.
Not as a cuisine thingy.
We know them as a disease-ridden ferment. Is that different?
Yeah, they're the ones, yeah.
They caused a pretty bad incident.
Do you just roast them, or do you boil them to get rid of the...
Well, first you gotta gut them. Yeah. Then you gotta defur them. Get rid of all the lice.
Wait,
lice?
If you
see worms in them, you cut out the part with the worms in them. But you don't always need to do that. It's sometimes alright.
Are you saying that there's worms in these things?
People eat them and crickets and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Rose, though, but...
No.
You have to season them, you gotta hang them, make sure you bleed them. If you don't bleed them enough, then that could be a problem.
Wait, why? Why you don't bleed them?
Well, a lot of diseases travel via the blood. So...
Did you bleed
if they
these?
Do have anything in particular, I didn't bleed these personally. No,
why
I get them
did
from
you? Okay,
some reputable source.
Okay, I'm gonna be quiet.
Do you guys have something that's called the Black Death?
That's what I was referring to by pretty bad.
With the undead.
Not yet. They don't have it. Not yet.
It's like a plague. The rats carry a plague that killed like a lot of people.
Oh, you mean like a were rat?
Wait, were? Rats? Is that what I think it is?
They're rat. I say pointing at the roast.
Well, it's some... There's occasionally... sometimes people who eat an improperly prepared rat might contract were rats and become a rare rat.
Once a full moon, there's a chance I might become a big rat.
It's more of a more frequent than that.
I'm gonna regret asking this, but how frequent is frequent?
Well, it's kind of like
weekly, daily, hourly.
Oh, you can turn it on and off, mostly.
What do you mean mostly?
Well, there's some times where you can't. To be honest, the full moon does tend to stop you from being able to turn back for a bit.
Okay, that tracks with what we kind of know about werewolves.
Don't worry, my meat will be fine. He slaps the meat.
Am I fine in imagining a humanoid rat bipedal, extremely big?
Yeah.
With four turtles.
Teaching kung fu?
Yeah.
Oh, you guys referring to the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles?
Yeah.
Oh god, I got that reference. I am so happy.
Alright. Yeah. Now, meat men. Good luck with your vermin. And let's hope I will never eat your meat again.
Actually, I have one more question. I have a question, sorry. Hello. So if my friend here... Well, actually... Friend? Yeah, sure. Contracts wherever. How soon will she know?
Probably first night.
Okay, so we don't have to wait too long to see whether this will be a problem or not.
So we have to lock her up.
Do you like stake them with a piece of wood or like use silver?
Silver?
Silver, yeah, that would work. Pure silver, though. Knobbing the head off would also do it.
Guys, I like my head.
And we like our body intact.
Yeah. Let's not casually discuss, you know, that sort of thing. Anyway, we need
to... You don't need to discuss this anyway, because my meat is 100% certified by Jared.
Who's Jared?
Who's Jared?
There's this guy that sometimes travels around and sells carcasses.
What? Wonderful. Okay, so I'm going to go to this herbalist and ask about this lotion. If you guys want to continue this conversation here, I'm more than happy for you to, but I am out. I'm sorry.
I am following Brendan.
I follow them. What is this Jared sell?
Carcasses. So, bodies of animals.
So please add a little annotation to that quote on who said it to you, because I have no idea who.
What?
I will never eat your meat again.
Not me, surprisingly.
It was not you.
That was David.
Okay, I'll make a note for that later. Anyway, so Brandon's...
In the list.
I'll add you to the list, not to worry. But for
me, I slowly start taking a python out of my bag as Kara is walking closer.
I feel fine, guys. It was really good.
Mm-hmm.
It starts to get a weird sensation.
Are you also eating that, June?
It feels like you have a tail. You feel it swishing back and forth.
Wait a minute, guys. I have a tail! I see holding my tail in front of me.
I start lifting the python. What?
Are you eating a snake?
No, the thing for tents. What's it called? A piton?
Piton?
Oh, yeah, piton? For the hammer stake thing.
Yeah, I mean the nail kind of looking tail. Well, how do you say it?
Come on, guys, it's a joke. You don't have to take it so serious. I say just like spinning my tiefling tail around one hand, casually.
Walking with mighty thin ice right now.
I truly hope that you won't be disease ridden.
When she goes to sleep, should we lock her door from the outside?
If I turn into a rat, can I just crawl under the door?
Oh, we don't need any more. Yeah.
We have two, like, rodents living in the place at that point.
Yeah, one is enough.
Yeah, and they're an asshole.
Is this why Kara has been asking about the cheese as well? If it was already, like, starting. Four.
Listen, I'm all for banter, but I wouldn't compare that back to my worst enemy.
Kara, in what year were you born?
Yeah, but we don't know that anyway, so what would be the point in
answering? No, I need to know.
Wait, this isn't that horoscope shit, is it?
No, I'm trying to see if she's born in the year of the rat.
Oh, right, okay, I approve.
Does time in this universe work as ours?
I guess.
We came from our universe.
Funnily enough, I was born in the year of the rat.
Oh, why?
1996.
96? Yeah. You're from 96?
I'm 27. I'm from 96.
Fun fact, this year is actually, the year of the rat.
Actually, that would be... Oh, yeah, then I was born in the year of the rat too. We're the same age, aren't we?
Are we?
Yeah. Well, I suppose it's never come up in conversation before, but yeah, we are, I guess, then.
Oh, you are kind of old.
Hey, not... What have I told you about that? I am only as old as I feel. I've still got my whole life ahead of me, ostensibly. But, yeah, you've... Yeah.
Brendan is going through a midlife crisis, don't worry about him.
That's...
How old are you? Oh, no, I know that.
You...
I mean,
how old are you, June?
19. I was born in like 2006, something like that.
Oh, so you're pretty old then.
So 14.
It'd be like 19, I think, if I'm
yeah, I'm also 19.
It was a rough year. It was a rough year.
Now you're 17. Or maybe 18. Depends on.
Oh, no, she's from the year of the dog. Oh my, but maybe she can turn into a rare dog.
Alright, on to Granny's.
Yes, I've been trying to get here. You keep stopping me.